أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
لا أقسم بهذا البلد.
I swear by this city, Mecca.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لا أقسم بهذا البلد. Verily, I swear by this city, that is Mecca. Mecca was hard for living. No vegetation, nothing grew over there. Bewadin ghair zizar. Not an easy or pleasant place to live.
وأنت حل بهذا البلد.
And you, O Muhammad, are free of restriction in this city.
وَأَنْتَ حِلٌّ بِهَذَا الْبَلَدِ. Over and above that, and you, O Prophet, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you are a dweller in this city, and you will be permissible in this city. What does it mean? Number one, that people are persecuting you here. First of all, the city is hard to live. And now you are having the hardship because these disbelievers, they are opposing you. They are calling you names. They are saying you have gone mad. So this is another toil, another suffering, another dimension of suffering. And the other meaning is, that you will be permissible. One day will come, and that is the victory of Mecca, when you will be allowed to make warfare in this city. Otherwise, it is forbidden city. This is Baladul Haram. No fighting here. And this was the tradition of the Arabs, that even if a person was searching for the killer, murderer of his father for years together, I couldn't find him. But then he saw him in Mecca, in Haram. But he won't say anything to him. Don't do any harm. He is in Mecca. This is Baladul Amin, Baladul Haram. But one day will be for you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This ban will be lifted. Your struggle will reach that place. 13 or 14 persons were killed on the day of the victory of Mecca.
ووالد وما ولد.
And by the father and that which was born of him.
ووالد وما ولد. And another manifestation of this toil and hardship. The begotten and the begotten. Now father has to look after the child, to provide for the child. This is not an easy job. Rearing the children, bringing them up, hardship over hardship.
لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي كَبَدٍ.
We have certainly created man into hardship.
لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي كَبَدٍ. We have created man in hardship and toil.
يحسب أن لن يقدر عليه أحد.
Does he think that never will anyone overcome him?
أيحسب أن لن يقدر عليه أحد. Does he think that nobody will be able to have power over him?
يقول أهلكت مالا لبدا.
He says, I have spent wealth in abundance.
يقول أهلكت مالا لبدا. And he says boastingly, well, I squandered abundant wealth in charity. They used to boast. I fed so many people. I helped so many people. أيحسب أن لم يره أحد. Does he think that nobody observed him? If he was doing for Allah, so Allah is seeing. He has seen. No use saying it. But if it was to show off to the people, then you will have no reward from Allah. Simple. يقول أهلكت مالا لبدا
يحسب أن لم يره أحد.
Does he think that no one has seen him?
أيحسب أن لم يره أحد. Now the blessings on man.
ألم نجعل له عينين.
Have we not made for him two eyes?
ألم نجعل له عينين. Didn't we give him two eyes to see?
وَلِسَانًا وَشَفَتَيْنِ
And a tongue and two lips.
وَلِسَانًا وَشَفَتَيْنِ And a tongue and two lips, with the help of which you speak.
وَهَدَيْنَاهُ النَّجْدَيْنِ
And have shown him the two ways.
وَهَدَيْنَاهُ النَّجْدَيْنِ And we guided him to the two highways. Now the interpretation of these two highways is number one. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put, as we shall find in the next surah, the knowledge of good and evil is inherent in human souls. So as if Allah has already guided them. This way is wrong, this way is correct. This is good, this is bad. Telling a lie is bad. Speaking the truth is good. Everybody knows. Fulfilling the promise is good. Going back on their promise, bad. To be respectful to your parents, good. To be disrespectful, bad. Who doesn't know it? So we have already guided him to the two highways. But another interpretation is, that the breasts of the mother, the child is born, baby, knows nothing. But as if some had taught him, someone, that your food is there, in the breasts of your mother, go and suck it. Nobody has to train him. If that training was not already given to him, how would you feed that baby? So this is the other interpretation, and I prefer this interpretation.
فَلَقْتَحَمَ الْعَقَبَةِ
But he has not broken through the difficult pass.
فَلَقْتَحَمَ الْعَقَبَةِ Despite our blessings, man has not been able to cross the narrow valley, which is very high. Aqaba. In high mountains, narrow valleys, Man didn't cross them. What do you mean by that? The explanation is coming in the following ayat. What is that?
وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا الْعَقَبَةِ
And what can make you know what is breaking through the difficult pass?
وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا الْعَقَبَةِ Do you know? What will make you understand what is this? عَقَبَة What is this narrow valley at the height?
فَكُّ رَقَبَةٍ
It is the freeing of a slave.
فَكُّ رَقَبَةٍ Freeing of a slave. You set a slave free. Service to mankind. Sympathy with your human fellow beings. To be able to spend your money to relieve your fellow beings from pain and suffering. This is the narrow bottleneck which man, due to his miserliness, niggardliness, stinginess, he can't cross due to love of wealth. فَكُّ رَقَبَةٍ
أَوْ إِطْعَامٌ فِي يَوْمٍ
Or feeding on a day of severe hunger.
Or feeding on a day of hunger. When there is famine, when there is drought. And if you have some store of grain, some stock, Normally you like to keep it. But whosoever can share this with the fellow beings, although he sees that maybe he will need it tomorrow, but no. إِطْعَامٌ فِي يَوْمٍ ذِي مَسْغَبَةٍ
يَتِيمًا ذَا مَقْرَبَةٍ.
An orphan of near relationship.
يَتِيمًا ذَا مَقْرَبَةٍ. An orphan who is also a relative. قرابتدار. Who is a kin.
أَوْ مِسْكِينًا ذَا مَتْرَبَةٍ.
Or a needy person in misery.
أو مسكيناً ذا متربة, or a needy man lying in the dust. This is the narrow valley which you cross. That is, you have let loose the brake. The love for wealth is the brake. Your car cannot go. You are pushing the accelerator. But the brake is there. Your car cannot move. So whatever you try, you cannot be a righteous person unless you are relieved of this love for wealth. And this subject we have read in detail in Suratul Hadid. اَلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ يُحْيِي الْأَرْضَ بَعْدَ مَوْتِهَا قَدْ بَيَّنَّا لَكُمُ الْآيَاتِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَعْقِلُونَ إِنَّ الْمُصَّدِّقِينَ وَالْمُصَّدِّقَاتِ وَأَقْرَضُوا اللَّهَ قَرْضًا حَسَنًا يضاعف لهم ولهم أجر كريم والذين آمنوا بالله ورسله. Those who pass this narrow bottleneck and then they have faith, then you know their character, their moral character, it will go up and up and up. But you have to open the brake first, and that brake is the love of wealth. When you have passed this through this narrow valley,
ثُمَّ كَانَ مِنَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْمَرْحَمَةِ.
And then being among those who believed and advised one another to patience and advised one another to compassion.
ثُمَّ كَانَ مِنَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْمَرْحَمَةِ. And then you join those people who have faith, who believe, and who exhort each other for patience, and exhort each other for compassion. Now this is Suratul Asr written over here. Wal Asr, inna al-insana lafi khusr, illa al-lazina amanu, wa amil salihati, wa tawasaw bil haqti, wa tawasaw bil sabr. The only difference is, amil salihat has been taken first. Freeing a slave, feeding the hungry. This is Amal-e-Saleh. In Suratul Asr, Iman, then Amal-e-Saleh. Then Tawasi bil-Haq, then Tawasi bil-Sabr. Here the sequence is different. The most important Amal-e-Saleh, sympathy for your fellow beings. فَقُّ رَقَبَةٍ أَوْ إِطْعَامٌ فِي يَوْمٍ ذِي مَسْغَبَةٍ يَتِيمًا ذَا مَقْرَبَةٍ أَوْ مِسْكِينًا ذَا مَتْرَبَةٍ. Mentioned here. Now you join that band, that group, that Hezbollah, who has faith, and they exhort each other, sabr for sabr and marhaba.
Ulaika ashabul maymanah.
Those are the companions of the right.
Ulaika ashabul maymanah. These are the people to whom their records will be handed over in their right hands.
وَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِآيَاتِنَا هُمْ أَصْحَابُ الْمَشْأَمَةِ.
But they who disbelieved in our signs, those are the companions of the left.
وَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِآيَاتِنَا. As for those who belie our revelations, هُمْ أَصْحَابُ الْمَشْأَمَةِ. They are the people to whom their record will be handed over in their left hands.
عليهم نار مؤصدة.
Over them will be fire closed in.
عليهم نار مؤصدة. They will be in the fire, but the fire will be vaulted over, closed from upside. You know, if there is an oven and it is closed from above, then all the heat is within. If there is some opening, then heat goes out also. But closed, muqsada. Alayhim narun muqsada. Now let me give you an introduction. Two pairs of two surahs each going to make a chahar surah, a collection of four surahs. Chahar surah of Noor and Zulmat, light and darkness. There are opposites in this universe, good, bad, height and low, all these things, contradictions. But with these contradictions, this universe is working. And without these contradictions, there would be no working of this universe. But there is another contradiction, and that is within you. The urge to do good and the urge to do bad, evil. Both are within you. You have the nafs-e ammara, which is urging you for something bad. Inna nafsa la ammaratum bisu. You have that spirit. It wants to pull you up towards your Lord. So, this noor and zulma, light and darkness, as they are opposed to each other, in the same way, good and evil, they are opposed to each other. So in these surahs you will find, in the first, eight ayat consist of oaths and very small, you know, statement on which this oath has been taken. In the next surah, there will be three ayat for oaths, and then on what the oath is taken, it is detailed somewhat. Then the third is Surah Al-Duha, the highest level to which a human can rise. And that is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, talking to him personally at an absolutely personal level. Surah Al-Duha and Surah Al-Inshirah. These four surahs, very beautiful, very important, and the subject gradually develops. As if you know, there is a flower bud. It has not exfoliated. The petals are there in that bud, but they are not visible. When this flower opens up, this bud, now the petals are visible. So you will find, you know, the gist, the essence in the first surah.